This is a forward shoulder roll, commonly referred to as a forward safety roll. Basically, if you ever fall off something in heights, see those guys doing parkour, they jump off buildings that are 30 feet in the air, and they land, they roll and roll and roll, they transfer that energy. This is where that comes from. This is how you save yourself how to tuck and roll. It's a basic drill. Julie's gonna come over here, she's gonna put her right foot up here. She's gonna take a step. Your hands are gonna go in the opposite direction together. A little closer together. What you have to do is you have to tuck your chin in and roll. The idea is you're gonna tuck your chin in and look towards your back knee. What we're gonna learn how to do is we're gonna learn how to spot this as she's doing it. So hands down. The idea is I'm gonna help scoop her chin in. This will give and create forward momentum. As I'm doing that, I'm putting my hand on her midline and throwing her over. Okay, she's going to roll on this shoulder. It's right leg, right shoulder. She's going forwards, but she's still angled, so she's protecting her neck and being safe. So hands down, chin in, tuck and roll. She stands up. That's all it is. So let's do that again, and I want you to pay close attention to her feet when she gets up. She does not cross her ankles, because that's how you break an ankle. Her feet become square, it's like a squat. So right foot down, hands down. Set up first, take your time. Don't get nervous. Tuck your chin in. Good. My hand's gonna go in the back of her neck, it's gonna help scoop it in. The other hand, underneath the midline, push her forward, she rolls, her feet come apart, she stands up. Okay, the exact same thing on the other side, just not to the left. Left foot there, hands down, set up, chin is locked in. If she doesn't know where to do it, put her chin there. Put your chin down. Tuck your chin in, roll, and it's a gentle glide. Some people get scared of this. If they get scared, you have to ease them into it. They might get nervous, they might not know where the hell they are in space and time. The idea is I'm helping her as she moves, I cannot force her to this movement. If I force her, she's gonna hate me forever. She's gonna get nervous.
I'd say even as a gymnast, after training for years to go nice and straight and down the line and stay square, that this is still, it does throw you off your center. So it might be normal for you because this is maybe how you roll around, but it's funky because you're not going down a straight line. You're putting a little twist to it.
Can you show one where you don't go straight?
Yeah.
In other words, most people will go in the direction of the row rather than controlling it. Yeah, I mean from your position. That was a beautiful standing forward. So come back to your, so he's going to spot you. Right, it's a shoulder row.
Yeah.
But go in the direction of your shoulder row. We're going to go off the mat.
Gotcha.
Most people will go that direction, right? Well, you want to control where you're going. All this is a tuck and roll for a controlled what? A controlled fall. So watch her again. Now she'll take it and go the right direction with the force.
She may be falling. The roll is coming straight out.
Cool? All right. I know this seems really, really almost condescending of a movement. There was a girl here at the last advanced course that had just unbroken and fearless on her shirt. Would not do this. And I'm like, you know, you need to take that fucking shirt off because it doesn't apply to what we're asking you to do here. But where this also is like in daily life, when you see people fall, what do? Their first reaction is to try to stop the fall rather than rolling with the energy and coming out of it. I tell this at a level one. My last high-rise drill in the fire department, we had to go up 40 flights of stairs with a 50-pound high-rise bag, and we were already wearing 84 pounds worth of gear. I got to the last step of the last flight and I missed it. I've fallen back. I drop the pack, I turn around, and I tripod roll down so I don't break my arms. I was bruised up a little bit because it's not fun to roll on stairs, but you got to know how to fall when it comes time to do that. In gymnastics, when you guys start doing a punch front or a handspring that's forward handspring, if you have a problem with it, you go to your tuck and roll and get out of it. Make sense? You ready? Okay.
Remember what I said before about one hand always assisting and one hand always rotating? This hand is assisting the chin in, this one is rotating them over. Cool?
Tuck chin. Good. Keep legs together as you roll out. Good.
Good.
There you go.
Take your chin, look at your back leg.
Here in
your side, and go.
And let me give a cue for everybody, because everyone loves to do this. Smell your armpit. That means put your nose tucked in underneath that armpit, right? You should be smelling your own odor. Everybody likes their own brand, all right? Here we go. Ready. Leg up, tuck and roll. Nice. Tuck and roll. Good. Ready. Tuck and roll. Look at your stomach. Good. Again, tuck and roll. Hey, when you go to opposite side, Remember, the head's going to go to the other side to tuck, right? Okay. One thing in this, just kind of watching you guys spot a little bit, always go with the spot, and this is the one thing that, you know, in a deadlift, we're obviously not touching anybody. We give our cues verbally, right? We show it, we watch it, but we don't really come up and put a hand on the lower lumbar curve and say, well, you need this here, right? Because then we get in the way. But in gymnastics, it's always hands-on in the beginning. So go ahead and put your hands down, get ready for the roll. So I've got her smell in her armpit. She's right up here ready to go. Once this hand is here, it stays here. And here's why. Raise your head up for me. If she raises that head up and tries to roll that direction, I can push that down. Right? And if I see somebody do, like, raise your head up and they do this and step away and tell them to row, well, we got a problem. I mean, we can injure C1 through C7 real quickly. So always have a hand on them. Go ahead and row for me, please. Tuck and row. And we follow the movement all the way through. Once you got a hand on them, it doesn't go away from them. They row with it, you row with them, and let them accept the energy, and you stay with that energy as they go any direction that you're spotting them. Cool? Don't go like, well, she's got it, and back off, because you never know. You know, we're human, therefore we're fallible. We do stupid shit, right? And if they start to roll and look up, they're gonna hopefully just tweak their neck. Worst case, they could break it.